It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, everybody. We're back in the kitchen and it's all about the budget. Now, a healthy and a hearty meat-free comfort dish doesn't have to cost a lot of money. Our creamy red lentil dal curry is an easy to make delicious dinner that can be served with rice or, as we are doing today, crispy baked jacket potatoes to take your curry game to the next level. Mm-hmm. It smells again so good. So good.
I see you, Mama. You're doing well.
The spices, the flavor.
And that's them not even in the pot. And now to make it, we've got simple ingredients here. I've got some onion. I'm going to start frying up some curry leaves as well. I know most people, when they make such dishes, they want to add the stuff at a later stage. But I like to fry them up because, one, it releases the flavor. But then, two, it also releases the oils in the actual ingredient, allowing it to coat whatever recipe. Infuse even better into the recipe you're making. I've also got some cumin seeds, add some coriander seeds, or as people would say, some jeera, as well as some danya seeds going in there. And we're going to fry it up nicely because we want to release all those beautiful flavors. And then I'm also adding some dried chilies. And I've been taught that you decide how hot you want your curry or your dal to be. It's completely up to you. I don't know how hot you want it, Mama.
When I was in Durban 2 weeks ago, they served us curry and then they put chilies on the side as well. The curry was hot. And they said, no, but you have to try Durban this way. You have to eat the chilies on the side too. I was like, no.
I love my tongue.
It was good. It was great, but I was sweating off. It's like, I can imagine. It's good. Yeah,
and
the
What I also love about this recipe is that it's not only simple and easy, but it also is vegetarian. To the point of being vegan, because there's nothing, no animal product is your at all. So you can, if you are looking to omit and just be meat-free, like completely meat-free, this is perfect.
This is the way to go. Because it's yummy.
It's yummy and it packs so much flavor. And then a lot of people are looking at, I'm trying to get nutrients. I want to make sure I get as much of my nutrients. Lentils, perfect fiber, perfect protein as well. So you can definitely add them in there. I've added all my spices, if you can hear them popping. And now's the time for the lentils, because most people don't know that when we talk about dal, it's not necessarily the cooked dish. In loosely explained, it's like the split, in essence, to split. That's what we're talking about. So split peas, split lentils, split beans.
And it's not dal as in D-U-L-L, it's D-H-A-L, everybody.
Correct.
Just to let you know.
Thank you. Thanks for letting us know.
For the English. I'm teaching the English today.
And now the most important part, because we need to make sure that we cook this dish down and make sure it releases all that flavor. That's where our good hope soy comes in.
Gonna be so good.
Go soy good, girl.
And if you don't know what it is a dairy-free and it's great for drinking, as is baking and cooking like we're doing with this recipe today. It's also preservative-free as well as a source of protein, so ticking off all those boxes, and has good nutritional value. But Clover Good Hope soy milk is also high in omega-3 and low in sodium, so you're getting all those nutritional benefits. But like Chef Tumi said, red lentils is also a great source of plant-based protein and also helps to support heart health. So it's ticking off all those nutritional benefits, ticking off all the boxes.
All the boxes. And now, depending on how thick or runny you want your dal to be, you can then add more or less of our Good Hope soy. You can either add it more if you want it to be more of a runny, soupy consistency. But if you want like how we've got it here, you literally just want it to cover the split the lentils, and then it's going to cook down and thicken up and give you that beautiful mixture that you've got right there. I do not.
Okay, so our beautiful jacket pocket potatoes. Mm-hmm. I said it right? Jacket pocket potatoes?
Jacket potatoes.
We're fine. Let's just say jacket potatoes. I love these. Usually I'll put like some cream cheese and just some bacon in yana and some like a smoky. But this is beautiful. I usually make it in the microwave, which is, I know, probably a bad thing to do. But you bake these.
It's allowed.
I mean,
convenience is what it's all about, right? But I would always suggest you can do it in the oven. And when you do, don't poke with a fork. People think that that's the best way to do it because you want it to cook.
So how would you do it?
Don't do it, because what that does, it ensures that it cooks in the skin, the potato skin itself, and keeps it nice and structured and tasty and fluffy. Whereas if you do poke, it's going to still be nice. But I like to keep it nice.
Keep the juices in there. So when it does eventually, you have this, and then obviously you're going to put your beautiful dal, your red lentil dal curry on the top. I don't have a spoon right now, but
spatula.
The spatula. And we'll just fill it.
Spoon it nicely on top there. And that's a meal on its own. That is so filling because you've got the fiber coming from the potatoes. You've got the fiber and the protein coming from the lentils. Not only is it delicious, but it's also very filling. So you know that even though you're going meat-free, you still are going to get all the filling up in your tummy.
This is beautiful. And I would serve for dinner. I'll serve it for a lunch. You can just pop it into a snack box. ExpressoShow.com. I know you want to know where you can find your hands on the recipe. It is on ExpressoShow.com. I mean, now that dinner is served, it's time for some music.
Soy goodness from nature. Source of plant protein. Naturally cholesterol-free, lactose-free. Made with love by Clover.